Hello everyone. Welcome to our Sprouting webinar, which will be hosted by Professor Dr. Recep Külcü from Sparta University of Applied Sciences. He has been helping our team in Turkey a lot recently, almost a year now, using his expertise. He is engaged in promoting environmentally friendly practices in agricultural engineering, integrating his philosophical expertise to foster an ethical connection between the two. So, for us, he's a gem, and we are so thankful that he has accepted to join this webinar. And I will pass to Mr. Külcü now. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, Mrs. Nirgune Engin. Dear participants, welcome. I am Recep Kılıcı from Turkey. Today, I will talk about microgreen and micro-sprouts production and benefits of it. I want to share my presentation. Is it okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Evet. Why should we grow microsprouts and microgreens instead of seeds? There are many reasons. In short, this process increases the nutritional value and bioavailability of seeds. They also reduce the carbon and water footprints also. Additionally, during the droughts, we can use stored seeds and we use it to produce fresh food. Sprouting process where seeds come to life and grow until leaves begin to form. Sprouts not have a leaves also you can see the picture at the picture and microgreens have leaves and photosynthesis is begin in this stage. Both microsprouts and microgreens are rich in nutrients, but they have different features. For example, microgreens have take a photosynthesis. For these, it's have a high value vitamin C also, and you can see the sprouts, microgreen, baby vegetables, and vegetables. We like that because sprouts and microgreens can be grown at home without using any chemicals. And for microgreens, some growing media we need. Yes. Now I will explain some of benefits of microgreens and microsprouts. Lentils and plant-based protein sources similar nutritional contents with beef or other animal sources. But fat and cholesterol is high in beefs and other contents, other nutrients contents of lentils is higher than beef. This is the good for plant-based diets. And also carbon footprints of lentils is very lower than beef. You can see at this slide. How However, when we eat seeds without sprouts or greens transformations, we have some problems. These problems, when we consumed in seeds forms, anti-nutrients, because seeds have anti-nutrients compounds, and sometimes we have some digestive problems. When we produce microsprouts or microgreens, we can reduce the anti-nutrients, enrich nutritional content, and we produce bioactive compounds. Phytic acid and tannic acid is the anti-nutrient compounds. Especially phytic acid compound bound with iron and other micronutrients, and we cannot consume these micronutrients in the seeds. When we produce sprouts, we decrease the phytic acid by 75% and tannic acid by 60% also. And free amino acid is higher than seeds in the microsprouts, approximately increased 8 times, and soluble protein doubles, and fat decreased by 60% approximately. In the summary, microsprouts and microgreens remove anti-nutrients and create healthier food with more bioactive compounds. These compounds have anti-cancer and aging effects. This slide shows some of the bioactive compounds found in microsprouts and microgreens. Yes, we can talk about microsprout production, and I will show to you how can we produce microsprouts process. Sterilization is very important stage of this process, because seeds have some pathogenic microorganisms. For this reason, we have to use the sterilization stage, and we have to soaking approximately 8 to 20 hours. It depends on the seeds. Differences dif needs different soaking times also, but generally we use eight to 20 hour for soaking stage, and we have to moisturing every day seeds, and we can harvest these seeds. Sterilization is important stage, because seeds may have E. coli or Salmonella pathogens. For sterilization, we can use hydrogen peroxide. We use 3% hydrogen peroxide, and we have to dilute it with water at ratio 1 to 10 ratio. Okay, I want to show you. It's water, and I take the water 90, yes, 90 milliliter, and I will add to water 10 milliliter hidrojen peroksit. Can you see? Yes, I have a good solutions for sterilization stage, and we use this solution for soaking stage. I take it to jar my solutions, and this is seeds of mung bean. Mung bean is perfect seeds for microgreen and micro sprout production. And we can go to the next stage for sorry. We wait it for 8 or 20 hour in the, for soaking. After the soaking, we will take seeds from solutions. I can use this material. After the 8 hour, I take it from take it my seeds from solutions and continue to moistening stage. Every day we will moisture this material, this seeds. It's not dry out for this reason. We can use the spray for every day. And take it out. After the 1 week, our sprouts is sprouting process is completed, and it's I will show the completed sprouts. You can see the sprouts of this mung bean sprouts after the 1 week process. You can sorry. You can harvest at this stage, and you can use for salads or some cooking. You can use it in the cook some cook. Yes. At the microgreen stage, we can use these sprouts and continue the process for microgreen production. But we have to use different conditions for microgreen process. This process, microgreen process, sprouting, after the sprouting, we have to use growing media, and we have to use lighting. Sprouts not need to light. We have to take this at dark room. But microgreens needs to light for photosynthesis, and we have to moistening it also similar to micro growth production. Okay, and you can harvest it. Yes, we have to produce sprout for microgreens, and we have to choose one growing media. This is you can use soil. Also, you can use cocopeat. Also, special microgreen mats or only water. I don't use any growing media. I generally use water for producing microgreen production. And light is very important for microgreens, but microgreens not need more light for this reason. Sometimes strong light, higher light, direct solar radiation sometimes is bad conditions for microgreen. For these reasons, artificial lighting operation is more suitable for microgreen production. And I want to show you. This is my sprouts. I take it the this material. And we use similar to sprouting operation. We have to spray with only water, not need any chemicals or sterilization solutions. We can use water, and we have to use sunlight or artificial light. Artificial light, sometimes we use growing light, maybe you know purple light, blue and red light used for photosynthesis. And we can harvest your after the 1 week, approximately after the 1 week, you can harvest your microgreens. I want to show you some example for my laboratory. This is the mung bean sprouts. Approximately 10 centimeter length. It's a big sprouts, maybe macro sprouts. This is macro sprouts. Okay. And this is mung bean microgreens. We use artificial lighting, purple lighting for growing light. And this is mung bean microgreen. Okay, we use also sometimes also we use microgreen growing mats. And some specific lights we use or tested it, different color light we will test. And we have hydroponic equipment for other agricultural production. Thank you for listening. I hope this presentation was helpful. I would have to happy to answer any question.
I can ask the first question, Professor Kulcu. I had problem with having the microgreens transfer into the light. Should it be on the fifth day or the sixth day? Which is the best day to transfer the microgreen to
Okay.
light?
It depends on the seeds. Sometimes, for example, for mung beans, approximately after 1 week. But beluga lentil, it's maybe 10 day. It depends of the seeds, type of seeds. You can see the leaves. Can you see the leaves? You can transfer to microgreen production. But maybe you can see the leaves, these micro leaves. Maybe after 1 or 2 days, the leaves is more higher than this stage. At that stage, you can transfer it to microgreen production.
Thank you so much. There is a question from Monique. Can seeds get too old for sprouting?
Okay, some pathogenic problems for pathogenic problems. Yes, if you can use hydrogen peroxide or you can use vinegar. Vinegar also can be used for sterilization purpose, for sterilizations. You can use any vinegar and dilution rate is same with hidrojen peroksit. Yani şeyleri karışım oranları 1'e 10 olabilir. Yani onu öyle de çevirebilirsin. İkisinde de 1'e 10 oranında karışım yapılabilir. Bu şekilde de.
Okay, Monique, it is appropriate to use vinegar instead of hydrogen peroxide, and the percentage is same, 1 to 10. You can use vinegar instead of Mr. Kulcu's prescription. I hope this answer helped you. And oh yes, I will first read Stephanie's comment. I used to sprout, but I stopped when I found out about the risks of pathogens. I'm glad you explained that. Yes, that is very important. Thank you, Stephanie. Is sodium hypochlorite good for
Yes.
sterilization as well?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. It can be used for this.
Yes. Yes. Okay.
Hydrogen peroxide affect the enzymatic activity for sprouting stage. Hydrogen peroxide more suitable sterilization solutions. Not affect the only pathogens, also activate the enzymatic activity.
Yes.
Yes. One question. Bu yüzde
Evet.
düşük mü diye bir soru vardı
Evet.
ama
Hidrojen peroksit 3%.
3%, but we have to dilute it with water. Yani %3'lüğü 1'e 10 oranında biz seyreltiyoruz. Onu siz çevirin de bir hata olmasın. O önemli bir durum çünkü.
Hydrogen peroxide is 3%, but we have to dilute it 1 to 10 water. The usage is like that. And Dennis, I think your question is answered. Hydrogen peroxide also activates the nutrients, the growing process. That's why
Yeah.
we prefer it. And Monique, thanks. And Deniz, you mean bleach? Do you ask for bleach? Çamaşır suyunun içeriği de mi aynı? Hidrojen peroksit değil, değil mi?
Aynı değil. Aynı.
No, it's not same, Deniz. It's not bleach.
Hidrojen peroksit breakdown with light. It's advantage of hydrogen peroxide. At the light conditions, hydrogen peroxide break down and it's not harmful, but bleach may be harmful for human health.
Do you use the sterilization solution for moisturizing the seeds during sprouting phase or just plain water?
Yes, you can use solution for moistening process also, but it's not necessary.
Yes,
You can
not
use,
necessary.
but not necessary.
Yes. Okay. Monique says, how much vinegar should be used to wash after the soaking process?
Not after the soaking process. In the soaking process, we can use a vinegar also. Yani şeyin hidrojen peroksit yerine o şeyi de kullanabiliriz. Ama şeyin sirkenin aktive yani enzimatik aktiviteyi aktive edici özelliği çok az.
Monique, we use vinegar during the soaking process in the very beginning. From 8 hours to 12 hours, we use the vinegar 1 to 10%, and after, we keep moisturizing with plain water.
Göremedim
I
ben soruyu ama.
buna cevap verdim, aynısına cevap verdim. Stephanie says, if you could explain it again, would appreciate it. Most people don't explain it. It's important, it's safe. How long do you soak them in the hydrogen peroxide? It is between 8 to 12 hours, Stephanie.
Yes.
I will write down 8 to
Şöyle bir durum var. Hani eğer sadece sterilizasyon amacıyla hidrojen peroksit kullanacaklarsa suyla seyreltmeyi azaltıp süreyi kısaltabilirler. Ama bu şeyi tabii karışık durum da anlatmam benim o yüzden zor. Yani suda bekletme süresini değiştirmeden diyelim ki 8 saat suda bekletecekler ama sterilizasyonu daha kısa sürede yapmak istiyorlarsa %3'lükte yani 20 dakikada bekletebilirler.
Bire kaç oranında o zaman?
Yo, hiç seyretmeden 20 dakika bekletebilirler. Ondan
Aa.
sonra alabilirler. 20 dakikada steril hale gelir ama orada da enzimatik aktiviteyi aktive edememiş oluyorsunuz yani.
Okay.
O yüzden 1 bölü 10 oranında %3'lüğü seyreltiyoruz. 8 saat bekletiyoruz. En doğrusu bu yani. Biraz karışık olduğu için siz anlatırsanız daha iyi olur.
Explained a longer one, which is you can make this process 20 minutes long. It is so easy. You can use 3% hydrogen peroxide, and in that solution, just hydrogen peroxide without any water, you can keep it for 20 minutes and it is sterilized if you don't want to wait for 8 to 12 hours. But on the other hand, if you prefer this process, then the enzymes would not be activated. Therefore, the seeds will not be enabled to grow as good as you use the first way. I mean, keeping it all night long. I hope this helps. Please let me know if it doesn't help. And okay. Okay, I think Stephanie gets it. So, is there any question I missed? Please warn me. Okay, and Mr. Külcü warned us during his trainings with us, the workshops, that starting with mung beans is the best because
Yes.
they work the best. If you start trying this process with mung beans, you would be, encouraged to continue. If you start with beans or chickpeas, then you might fail in the beginning and you might be discouraged. So he strongly advises you to try mung beans first.
Second material, beluga lentils.
Belugas
It's
also.
also good for sprouting and microgreen production.
Okay.
Yes, brokoli sprouts is also best for nutritional contents.
Yes.
Also radish, red radish, microgreens, different nutritional contents. Yani bu farklı ürünleri mikro yeşillerini ve mikro filizlerini üretmek, çeşitlendirmek çok daha faydalı. Burada yani dediğim gibi turp, brokoli, bir de alfalfa yani şey yonca, bir de ayçiçeği hani bunları önerebiliriz diyorlar.
I will write down all the seeds and beans he recommends because the variety of nutrition he is recommending is the best. Alfalfa, brokoli. Neydi başka?
Radish, red radish, turp.
Bir
Turp herhalde.
şey daha vardı. Yonca mıydı?
Yonca, yonca
Bir tane daha var. Dördüncü neydi?
alfalfa zaten. Ayçiçeği, sunflower.
Safla. Okay. Okay, I wrote
Corn
down.
also good seeds for micro sprouts and green. Deniz variety, yes. Corn also. After the sprouting, how much winegar should you rinse with? Yani şeyi soruyor. Daha önce de sordu ama bu işlemden sonra ne kadar sirke kullanırız diyor. İşlemden sonra kullanacağımız sirkenin çok anlamı yok aslında. Biz bunu işlemden önce yapıyoruz. Yani bu soaking. We use vinegar at in soaking stage, not after sprouting.
I
Starting
mean,
stage, start stage.
he doesn't, he says you do not need to rinse the sprouts in vinegar afterwards. If you want, you can, but it is essential that you use it during the soaking process. But if you want to make sure before consuming it, you want to rinse it in vinegar, maybe just a spoonful would be enough, right? Bir kaşık koysa bir
Yani
şey.
şey yine 1-10 yani 1-10 yapacak yani.
One to ten is good for rinsing as well. I
Bir
hope
Monica
this
Pablo el mi kaldırdı birisi bir şey var ama.
helps. Kimse kaldırmadı. I think Monique, your question is answered, right? If you want to rinse, it is one to ten again. But the main thing is to use it in the very beginning to avoid the pathogens. Okay. I can see. Also, I think Mr. Kürci pointed out that it was the very interesting, the most interesting thing for me to learn that if you use micro seeds and micro greens at the same time, then you will get the maximum protein and the bioactive materials at the same time, because the sprouts contain double of protein, but the microgreens contain like from 20 to 80 times more than the seed itself. Okay. Sue is asking, what quantity of dried beans should you start with for soaking? Ben...
Depends of your needs. Yeah.
Yes.
Yani kabın boyutuna da bağlı tabii ki, çok da doldurulamaz ama hani o tamamen koşullara bağlı. Önemli olan suyun en azından materyalin iki katından fazla üstünde olmasına dikkat etmek gerekiyor.
So it depends on the jar you use. For example, with this size of jar, I would say one spoonful of mung beans would be enough. But with Mr. Külcü's jar, you see it's a bigger one. Maybe 2 to 3 spoonfuls would be good in that. And you see the second jar, it is just so big. The sprouts grow so quickly. And those 3 spoonful mung beans grow into like
Bu aslında kötü bir örnek. Bunu gösterebilirsiniz. Yani çok fazla doldurduğunuzda böyle hani içinden alması da zor bir hale geliyor. Ama büyüyor bakın, hani şey yok, sıkıntı yaşanmamış ama sığmamış. Yani buradan da genişletmiş. Yani bu kötü bir örnek olarak da verebiliriz bu konuda bunu.
So he says this is a bad example for you. It is always good to start with small amounts because they multiply so much.
Evet.
For a small jar of, say, 1 cup, just 1 spoonful would be enough. Is there a chart that tells different soak times for different types of beans? Her şeyin ne derler, tohumun farklı bir
Evet, süresi var. Yani bununla
var.
ilgili bir tablo yok. Aslında bunu hazırlamak lazım belki de olarak. Ama bu konuştuğumuz materyaller için 8 saat uygun.
He says, good question. We do not have a chart for that, but we really need to create one. But for the things we have spoken so far, 8 hours is enough. For dried any bean, it is 8 hour for soaking is enough. But he will work on the chart. Thank you for asking this.
For example, chia or black wheat, daha kısa süreler onlar için yani.
Yes, for
Longer.
chia, for example, the process is shorter. So
Shorter.
yes,
Shorter.
good question. I will ask for the chart in coming weeks, and I promise to send you. That's amazing. From just 3 spoonfuls, yes, Sue. It is interesting. It was so nice to see them grow. And Jill says, I've had a hard time sprouting broccoli. Any suggestions?
Broccoli is not easy, compared with the mung beans. Maybe you can use hydrogen peroxide to support the enzymatic activity. Maybe soaking times maybe shorter than mung beans. But You can use hydrogen peroxide solutions.
Yes. Jill, did you try hydrogen peroxide for soaking when you tried sprouting broccoli? And did you, how, I, so, no, I couldn't see. If you did not, okay, this might help, Jill, and also keeping it for 6 hours would be enough. Please try that. Thank you.
Bu arada brokolinin mikro yeşili çok daha faydalıdır şeyden. Hani onu ayrıca söyleyebiliriz belki.
And he also adds that green of broccoli is healthier than the sprouting of broccoli. So he suggests that you keep on the process until 10 days, you know, see it blooming with the leaves. Not only use it as a sprout, but better to use it in microgreens.
Yes, you can buy at pharmacy. I can buy it also pharmacy. At the pharmacy, hydrogen peroxide solutions 3%. Pharmacy have only 3% hydrogen peroxide. Yani kimyasalcılardan alırlarsa yanlışlıkla yüksek çözünürlüklü, yüksek içerikli alabilirler. Eczaneden almak daha sağlıklı zaten. %3'lük satıyorlar çünkü onlar.
Okay, he suggests that you need to buy it from the pharmacist with 3% hydrogen peroxide. If you go to a vendor who sells chemical products, there might be other hydrogen peroxides with higher percentage, and he doesn't advise to use them.
Tehlikeli olabilir onlar ya da.
Even
Sanırım.
harmful, dangerous. So it's always best to buy from the pharmacist. Okay, I missed the start. Can we listen to replay? I'm interested in the health benefits for us and our mental environmental climate. Yes, we had it recorded, and you can watch it later in our YouTube channel. And the health benefits are unbelievable. I'm so happy that I learned all about it. We all know that they do not taste wonderful when we eat them plain, but when we use them in salads, if we have pickles with the sprouts, everything works. They turn into wonderful, delicious things. And do you need to use food grade HP? The HP nedir? Onu bilemedim. Hydrogen peroxide. Do you need food grade HP? I didn't get that.
Yani zaten %3'lük olan gıdada kullanılabilir bir ölçek zaten.
Yes,
Yıkama
zaten.
için de kullanılıyor da bizim ülkemizde çok yaygın değil de yurt dışında bu sebzelerin yıkanmasında da kullanılabiliyor. Onu da kullanabilirler yani.
Yes, this HP hydrogen peroxide it can be used for food, and 3% hydrogen peroxide diluted in 1 to 10% can be used even if you would like to rinse your vegetables,
Ya
not
önemli
even
olan aslında bunun yüzdesi. Mesela
but
bizim
percentage.
yaptığımız, şimdi benim bazı yaptığım çalışmalar var. Mesela %1'in üzerine çıktığımız zaman, yani biz bunu %3'lük kullanıp sonra onda bir oranında şey yapıyoruz ya, çözeltiyi zayıflatıyoruz. Biz bunu onda bir değil de işte yarı yarıya sulandırdığımız zaman mesela olumsuz etkiler çıkıyor. Yani bunun %1'in üzerine falan çıkmaması gerekiyor. O yüzden %10 çok güvenli bir aralık. Yani böyle orada enzimatik aktiviteyi hem aktive ediyor, öbür türlü bu kez bloke etmeye başlıyor. Önemli olan bizim için buradaki şeyin ne için üretilmiş hidrojen peroksit olduğu değil, hidrojen peroksitin yani dediğimiz reçetede %10 oranında seyreltilecekse %3'lük kullanılması yani.
There are two important points in this. The hydrogen peroxide label should show that it is 3% hydrogen peroxide, a bottle. When we are diluting it, it's important that we dilute 1 to 10%. If we dilute it like 0.5%, then the enzymes would not work. The nutrition stage would not work and it might be harmful. So two things are important: 3% hydrogen peroxide and diluting it when soaking 1 to 10%.
Evet.
I hope this helps. Okay. I bought chemical 12% hydrogen peroxide online, but can dilute it. Or best to buy the 3%.
Yani aldığını da seyreltebilir. %12'liği de seyreltebilir. Ama tabii su miktarını arttıracak burada. Yani %1'in altına düşürmesi gerekiyor. Öyle diyeyim. Yani %1'in üzerine çıktığı zaman biz şimdi %3'lüğü alıp 0,3'e düşürüyoruz. Yani yine o ölçekte yani bol suyla aynı ölçeğe getirebilirse kullanabilir. Ama
Yani 1'e 10 değil 1'e 40 yaparsa oluyor mu o
evet,
zaman?
evet, evet. 1'e 40 yaparsa olacak yani.
Okay, you don't need to throw it away, of course. You can use it by diluting it 1 to 40%. You know, once it is 12% hydrogen peroxide instead of 3, then we can use more water and the dilution will be 1 to 40.
Bir de
Thank you.
hidrojen peroksiti bekletirken dikkat etsinler. Yani ne kadar ışık geçirmeyen kaplarda satılsa da karanlıkta bekletmeleri gerekiyor. Yani %12 olarak aldığınız hidrojen peroksit ışık altında güneşin olduğu yerde kaldığı zaman düşüyor değeri. Zaten güzel bir özelliği bu. Yani yoksa bizim için de zararlı olabilir. Çok hızlı bir şekilde parçalanan bir bileşik. Hani o yüzden karanlıkta saklamaya dikkat etsinler hidrojen peroksiti. Özelliğini kaybedebiliyor yani.
Yes, and he strongly advises that you should keep your hydrogen peroxide bottle in a dark place because once it is under sun or under light, it uses its quality, and it's something good because when we are using it afterwards, when we are using for avoiding pathogens, in time it just goes away, it destroys itself. But when you are keeping it in the bottle, if you want to preserve it with same conditions, it needs to be within a dark place. There is a Rita has a question in Q&A and shelled mung beans. You mean Rita, are you asking about the name of the mung beans? They are the mung beans just shown on the hocam bir daha gösterir misiniz şeyi? The ones we cook at our şeyleri, maş fasulyesinin orijinal halini.
Yes.
These are the mung beans we can buy from the markets. And yes,
Yes.
when
Small
we
green
have
seed.
sprouting, yes, all the greens go away when we do the sprouting. The shells goes away.
Okay.
I hope this answers you.
Şey de söyleyebilirsiniz, bu yeşil kabuklarını ayrılıyor zaten hani şeyden. Ayırmakta fayda var. Yani bu yeşil kabukları hani kullanmamaya çalışsınlar. Onu da
Okay.
söyleyebilirsiniz.
It's important that when we are having the sprouting, you can see all the shells, all the green shells are going away. In case they are still there, it's best to remove them because they keep the tannic acid and phytic acid.
Yes.
So want to get rid of those. They are anti-nutritions. We want to have them go away.
This is ready for microgreen production. This growth. Can you
See
see
the
the leaves and length approximately 10 centimeters and root. You can see the root. It's ready for microgreen production.
Yes, this is the time to take the sprouts to the light. Not direct light, of course, because direct light is harmful,
Yes.
but just a light place. I mean, something in front of your window is good. When the size of the sprout is 10 centimeters. Okay. I think we have answered all the questions. If there are no other questions, we can say thank you to Mr. Kuju. Thank you for telling us about the miracle of sprouting. And I hope now everybody will try it. Thank you.
Thank
Thank
you.
you for joining. Oh, just one question. Do Sandra,
Ah, yes.
can you?
At the sporting basket.
Oh, Sandra, I think you are asking where to buy the grains. The grains are the ones we can buy from the supermarkets. Had the sprouting basket. The sprouting basket can be ordered online. It is so easy to they are cheap and easy. But Zainab, at home I use old jars.
Yeah.
It's also possible to use the jars. You don't need to buy them. It's okay to buy them, but you don't need at all. I use the jars at home. I hope this answers. Okay. Thank you so much, and hope to see you in another. I use jars, but sprouts never grow so long. Yes, that is correct, Zaina. Yes, this basket helps a lot.
This is the best for sprouting, but not sprouting jar. This is the ne diyeyim, bu
Shall we?
süzgeçli kap olarak geçiyor herhalde, değil mi? Ben tam da nasıl
Evet.
geçiyor? Turşuluk diye geçiyor bazen böyle.
We
Yani
use it to make pickles in Turkey or to have olives. I don't know. I will search it for you and try to find the link for you, Zaina. Could you please send me? I will write down my email. And please send me an email and I will search it for you. Yes. Okay. I copied your email also. Anyone having any questions, please do not hesitate to send me an email. I'm ready to answer. If I cannot answer, I will ask Mr. Kulju to answer and then transfer his answer to you, because I just want you to try it once, because it's so easy. In the beginning, it seems like it is something from the laboratory of a chemist, but it is not. We can do it. And when we do it, we will reach the real nutrients, and this will amaze us. I strongly recommend. And I will send you the emails, Aina. Thank you, everyone. And let's meet in another webinar, and see you soon. Goodbye.
Bay
Sağ
bay.
olun. Teşekkürler.
İyi akşamlar.
İyi akşamlar.